Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning. Thank you for joining us on this bright, brisk, and bold morning for urban aviation. My name is Andrew Kimball, and I'm president and CEO of the New York City Economic Development Corporation, known as EDC. As many of you know, EDC works on many different things across New York City, from huge transformative development projects like Willits Point in Queens, Sparks Kips Bay in Manhattan, and the recently announced Staten Island North Shore Action Plan. But we also manage 225 properties across 64 million square feet of space, over 170 different capital projects, all while working to grow the innovation sectors of today and the future, ensuring that we're building neighborhoods where people live, learn, work, and play. We're here today to mark a new chapter for one of our most popular assets by embracing new technology and partnering with the private sector to drive more sustainability in our city. This new vision is going to change New York City's skies and waterways for the better, improving the quality of life for all New Yorkers, creating a cleaner, greener, and quieter New York. If you look behind me, you might be wondering, what are those interesting looking helicopters, and is this a Westworld set? They are electric vehicle takeoff and landing aircraft, also known as eVTOLs, and they are the future of the aviation industry, providing quieter, more sustainable options for urban aviation. We're fortunate enough today to be joined by some of the leading innovation companies producing eVTOLs, including Joby and its CEO, JoBen Bivert, Volocopter and its managing director, Christian Bauer, and representatives from several other companies as well. Before I turn it over to the mayor, I want to make sure that I'm acknowledging some of the people who are here with us today who helped make today possible. On the city side, I, of course, want to thank my partner in everything we do, Deputy Mayor Maria Torres Springer, who continues to lead our city's recovery through her economic development, housing, and workforce portfolio. I want to thank DOT Commissioner Adonis Rodriguez, who's been an invaluable partner when it comes to bolstering and developing our blue highways, moving more goods on our waterways, reducing traffic on our streets, and more on that in a moment. I also want to thank our elected officials joining us here today, including Councilmember Chris Marte, Borough President Gail Brewer, Assemblyman Charles Fall, advocates Roland Lewis and Melissa Epstein from Stop the Chop, who have long pushed for quieter skies, and Stephen Jackson, the principal from Aviation High School. I also want to thank our partners at the federal level, particularly Tom Morcan, the Northeast Gateway Director at USDOT Maritime Administration, who've been working closely with us on our Piers and our Blue Highways initiative. Now, I have had the chance to collaborate with Eric Adams for over 20 years, first as state senator and then as Brooklyn Borough President when I led the redevelopments of the Brooklyn Navy Yard and Industry City. He's a man who cares deeply about economic development, public-private partnerships, and embracing new technologies. As the mayor has often said, this administration cannot be afraid to push the boundaries when it comes to innovation, and that's exactly what we're doing here today. Ladies and gentlemen, the Get Stuff Done Mayor, Eric Adams.
Thank you. Thanks so much, Andrew. I am just really excited about this moment, and I remember a few years ago when I was hearing about the electrification of a helicopter, I thought about you right away, because you complain about the noise all the time. And just to see the principal of aviation, high school, and these amazing companies, and watching how simple it is to use one of these devices, you know, within our lifetime, many of you are going to own your own personal electric helicopter. I mean, this is just unbelievable when you think about it. It's no different than a joystick on a video game, the partnership with the companies, allowing our young people to use it now in schools. We're going to have to build out mechanics. We're going to build out operators. We're going to build out who's going to build these helicopters. The pipeline is just unbelievable what we're about to accomplish here in the city. And I can't thank Andrew, EDC, and our amazing deputy mayor enough for realizing that we cannot be afraid of the future. This must be a city of yes, where we lean into the possibilities of not only what we do on the ground, but what we do in our skies. To be able to number one, move faster to and from our places, the airports or other locations, but to do it in a clean, green way and allow our young people to earn some clean, green dollars in the process as they learn how to operate these devices, repair these devices, and design these devices. This is only the first level. It's just unbelievable what the next evolution. Just think about, we went from a Walkman where we just had tapes, cassette tapes, to an iPhone or other Samsungs or other phones where we have everything on these devices. So this first evolution is just the beginning, and we are just excited here in the city. So really thank all of our partners for this amazing day that we are living through right now. We see this as the starting point, not the ending point. Our investment in this technology and the use of this technology is going to allow us to have cleaner skies and stay true to our mission that we stated all the time. Here at the downtown Manhattan heliport, we are going to establish the world's first heliport with infrastructure for electric-powered helicopters of this nature. The first one in this country. And we're going to reimagine the assets as a new hub for sustainable transportation. We're opening, as Andrew has mentioned, we're opening requests for proposals for a future operator of this site. It's a very important site. I've flown out of here from time to time. So they can build the transport infrastructure of tomorrow. This is a bold new vision on what we want to accomplish as a city. And now we know how important it is to just also bring down the noise. And as I just learned, how far the noise can travel. This is real science at its best and real opportunities. This project would also build out our blue and marine highway network. We have to get trucks off our street with the continuous use of delivery services to be able to move trucks off our streets and use our waterways and use a better infrastructure of delivery is going to help in cleaning our environment. So when you add all of this to the electric vehicles, the EV charging stations, when you look at the electrification of our school buildings, looking at our city fleet, you see a very aggressive move that we're doing as we move towards 2030. We are moving in the right direction. So you can feel the electricity in the air. You're going to see it in the air with this great, great innovation and introduction on how we're going to move around our city. Just really, hats off to the whole team, to all of you, my colleagues in government, for getting this stuff done. This is the continuation of our Working People's Tour. How do we get it right in our city? A city of yes. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor Adams. And I just want to build on a point that you made before I introduce our next speaker. Part of what we do at EDC in the city with this announcement is working to drive industry to a more widespread adoption of this technology. It's our responsibility to ensure that we're positioning New York at the forefront of this exciting new industry and preparing our assets to be ready to capitalize when this technology has widespread adaptation. And while EDC in the city does not control all of the heliports throughout New York City, and we certainly don't control the New Jersey heliports, where the majority of tour helicopter traffic comes from, we do control this heliport, and we control the one on 34th Street, and we're going to embrace this new technology at both. In addition to the aircraft behind us, we also have on display a charging cube over to my right. This is developed and provided by Beta Technologies, and I want to give a special thanks to them for joining us as well. This charger is the type of infrastructure that will be deployed at heliports to support electric aircraft. And to return to our Blue Highway strategy for a moment, you'll notice we have some cargo bikes here as well, highlighting the last mile and maritime freight component of this new transportation hub. Last year, EDC was awarded a $5 million federal grant to work on different piers throughout the city to put infrastructure in place to receive goods via waterways and utilize cargo bikes to reduce traffic on our streets. I encourage folks to get a good look at the rendering that we have here behind which shows what this new infrastructure will look like, with a special barge to the side where freight will come in small packages, get on these electric bikes, and get delivered to buildings and reduce truck traffic and emissions on our streets. And just a few weeks ago, we partnered with DOT on a new RFEI for the Blue Highways program to help us identify private partners throughout the city to use our waterways to move goods at this port and numerous landing sites throughout the city, further reducing greenhouse gas emissions while taking trucks off our streets and still getting us the goods we all depend on. Lastly, I just want to say, in every one of our economic development projects and initiatives, the mayor has made it very, very clear that it's not good enough to just gain back all the jobs we lost during COVID, not just bring back the same economy we had before, but to build a more vibrant and equitable economy. And that's why we're so focused on career pathway and opportunities in this new industry. And I'm very pleased to introduce Stephen Jackson, the principal from Aviation High School, responsible for teaching the next generation of pilots.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mayor. Mr. Mayor, for having me here today. Thank you to EDC for inviting me as well. My name is Stephen Jackson. I'm the principal of Aviation High School, and it's really exciting to be here because of this new, exciting and interesting and innovative new technology with Joby and all the variety of companies here today. Our school trains students to become aviation maintenance technicians, and a whole world of aviation opens up to them in New York City. It's a traditional public high school with an additional Federal Aviation Administration licensing pathway for airframe and power plant technicians. And we're really excited to be a part of this day today because as New York City takes on the eVTOL travel and encourages this whole new branch of aviation with the air taxi community, our students and future students can definitely become the future technicians and pilots and managers and a whole range of jobs that open up to them in this new career pathway. So as a public high school principal, I definitely would love to say that this new aircraft type is going to provide a lot of quick and easier transport for the residents of New York City, which is wonderful, but it also creates job opportunities and long careers for young people that really love to work with their hands, but also love new technologies, because this aircraft type will have electric propulsion, composite repair, variety and in-depth avionics, all the computer work that goes into it. So there's a lot of students out there that are interested in doing this type of work, especially when you add this new technology of the 21st century. So we're very happy to be a part of this community. And I have to also say, Mr. Mayor and everyone here today, New York City and New York State has had a long history in aviation. I think people forget. And it's really wonderful that you're encouraging this and developing this future aviation pathway for the residents of New York City and New York State, because it's a really important feature of our community to have these companies provide these opportunities for our young people and for the residents of New York. So thank you very much, everybody. I have to definitely say with that, Joby Aviation has been a wonderful partner in helping us develop the curriculum pathways for our students, for helping us train our students in the near future to get the jobs in this sector, so that our students can become fully certified and ready to work on their first day of graduation and be hit the ground running. So thank you, everybody. Congratulations to everyone. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you.
Thank you, Stephen. So before we move to the demonstration, happy to take any questions on topic.
Hi, I have a question for the mayor. From what I understand, the eVTOL are not yet FAA certified, so how far away are we talking about when this has become a reality? And same for the Blue Highways, like what's the timeline on this?
Yeah, what's exciting is that things are moving very fast on both fronts. We've been talking to the industry, obviously. We've been talking to FAA officials. And we fully expect that these will be operational commercially in 2025 or 2026. So within the next five-year contract for this heliport. So what we have done is put out an RFP for a request for proposals for operators of this site, and made as a requirement that they implement the kinds of infrastructure, the charging station, also the ability to bring in goods by freight that will facilitate both this site as a Blue Highway location and also as an eVTOL hub.
How confident are you in the safety of this helicopter if there's like a police boat, multiple fire boats, EMS, a stretcher? It's a little alarming coming up. Are we expecting something, or is that just a precautionary measure?
Well, no, we first of all, you got to always lean into the comfort of safety. This is, you know, new, so we want to make sure FAA is going to give us procedures and rules, FDNY, everyone is going to give us the procedures and rules when you're trying something new, no different than any other technology that's introduced, you know, but a version of this is already being carried out in other parts of the globe. So we're just listening to all of our safety folks. To make sure we do it right. And who doesn't like a fire man around us? We always like FDNY around us, you know, so it's a good feeling.
Mr. Mayor, I have a question for you. You know, you have had a major fixation on new technology, not only here, but robots and everything. I'm wondering if you think that, and your emphasis on that, that people are getting distracted by your legal problems.
Nah, we focus straight ahead. You know, this is a complicated city, an exciting city. Something is always happening in this city. Every mayor that I communicated with, from Bloomberg to de Blasio, to even when Mayor Dinkins, my mentor, was here, he says, Eric, listen, you wake up every day, if you're the mayor of the city of New York, something is always going on. 8.3 million people, 35 million opinions, and, you know, this is just the excitement of being in New York. You know, something is always going to be going on in the city, and you have to be focused, no distractions and grind, and that's what this administration is about, straight ahead.
Okay, so we're going to ask folks to stay seated. Oh, Mark, do you have one? Yeah, last one, and then we're going to go.
Okay,
we're talking about helicopters.
That sounds like a technology question, you know?
Good morning. My name is Joe Ben. I'm the founder of Joby Aviation, and this is our aircraft behind us. I'd like to start by saying thank you so much to Mayor Adams for ensuring that New York leads on this next incredibly exciting age of aviation. And then to Andrew Kimball and the entire team at the EDC, we are so, so grateful for the EDC leaning in to ensure that that the infrastructure is in place, the charging infrastructure is in place to bring this new age of aviation to life. To Stephen Jackson and the whole team at the Aviation High School, we couldn't be more thrilled about the work you're doing to prepare the pilots and the mechanics and all of the support staff that are gonna make this next age of aviation happen, the engineers, et cetera. You guys have been incredible partners. Deputy Mayor Torres Springer, Commissioner Rodriguez, thank you again very much for making this event possible. It is such an honor for us at Joby Aviation to have our aircraft here. Very, very pleased again with the announcement. This is one of the most iconic heliports in the world. And to be able to bring electric flight and the benefits of electric flight here is just a dream come true. One of the exciting aspects of electric propulsion is the speed at which you go from being completely silent to when the aircraft can be airborne. And the other aspect of it is that we're able to tune the acoustic signature such that it can blend into the background. So instead of the low frequency wop wop of the helicopters that travels for miles and penetrates buildings, the acoustic signature of our aircraft blends into the background, and it's just it sounds more like the noise of traffic or of a fan. And so this is one of the aspects that makes this such a game changer when we're talking about bringing this new mode of transportation to people around the world, and especially to here to New York. We have a a very close partnership with Delta Airlines, and we are working very closely with them to build out best-in-class takeoff and landing infrastructure that is tightly coupled with their terminals at LaGuardia and JFK. They've invested billions of dollars into those new terminals, and we are so excited to be building takeoff and landing locations connected to those terminals, working closely with the Port Authority so that a Delta passenger can go from their Delta flight and onto a Joby flight and be right here at the downtown helipad in just 7 minutes. We are filming the flight. This is one of the most iconic locations in the world, and it's amazing for us to have the opportunity to fly here. And again, the goal of this is to give all of you guys the experience of what this new type of aircraft can do. Another dimension of what makes this aircraft so special is that the propellers tilt from when they're in forward flight, and they tilt forward and to where it's wing-borne, and that allows the aircraft to fly at up to 200 miles an hour when it's on the wing, where it's flying very, very efficiently and at high speed. And as the mayor talked about, this is just the beginning. This is the first phase of a really exciting new age where instead of moving around on the ground, we're able to move around in the air. Our aircraft carries a pilot and four passengers and is completely sustainable. It's very exciting to this is a dream since I've had since I was little, and being able to fly this aircraft here in New York is just absolutely spectacular. And I can't tell you how thrilled the entire team from Joby is to be able to be here, and for all of you to be able to experience it. Oh, sure. That's a good sign that you can't hear it. Some people have had questions around the timeline. This is an incredibly exciting time for us as a company. We've been working on this technology for more than a decade, and we began certification with the FAA in 2018, and we're coming to the conclusion of the third stage of our certification process with the FAA. That's the having all of our area-specific certification plans approved. And we're deep into testing each of the components and systems so that we can prove out the full type certification, and we can launch launch our service. And so this is just an incredible moment, and we're really, really grateful for all of the support from everybody here in New York, from the EDC, the mayor, Aviation High School. It is just absolutely spectacular to be able to demonstrate our aircraft and bring this to all of you. The aircraft today is being piloted by Buddy Denham, our chief test pilot, who is was involved in building the control system for the Joint Strike Fighter. And one of the things that the mayor remarked about was how easy it is for these aircraft to be piloted. It makes it very, very intuitive, and we'd love to have all of you guys come out and fly the simulator when we install them at the Aviation High School. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to the team here at Volocopter, where they're going to showcase their incredible technology.
Thanks, Joe Ben. And here we go to the next flight. I will remain silent a bit. So basically, when we are around 100 meter distance, you will not hear it at all. I hope that the other helicopter now passes by. So Volocopter, a German company, we will get certified next year in Europe first, and have also great progress with the FAA in US. So also they follow our certification, so we will be ready in 25 to operate here. And it's a perfect use case for us to do a trip here, 20 minutes flight from A to B, with our aircrafts and our vehicles fully electric. We have 18 motors that provide safety, because one helicopter has typically one motor, one gearbox, and that's the issue, because if you have a mechanical problem, you have a problem and you're going down. So you see our pilot, he's performing a very smooth flight. I will now pause talking that you can hear it. Or even not. So you were able to still hear the helicopter, who was 300, 400 meter away, but we were in 100 meter when you could not hear it. In a typical city, it has an average 75 decibel. We are at 65 decibel at 100 meters pathway. So really amazing for doing that. Again, the most important, what Joe Ben also said, is safety, 100 times to 1,000 times safer than a helicopter because of our redundancy. That's important. Second is noise. You will not hear it, and it's very busy here and very loud. In the future, when those electric aircrafts come, you will not hear it at all, and will benefit to the public of doing that. Third one, fully sustainable during flight, fully electric. We do a battery swap after every flight so that we do not block the FATO, and then we can fly off immediately again from the platform. As I said, 18 motors, 9 lithium-ion batteries are powered on that aircraft, which is beautifully flying by. Those aircrafts will be perfect for a business ride. I landed last night at Newark Airport. It took me 1 hour 15 to go here. It's about 6 miles. It's a 10 minutes flight with an eVTOL fully electric here. I mean, I would have wished I had this technology already available, and we can start in 25, as I said. The company has around 600 employees, as I said, and a great kudos to FAA, who is now investigating how we can certify those aircrafts also here in US and on the collaboration with EASA in Europe, so to say. There are more than 200 to 300 models out there in the industry, but only a handful that really fly, and we try with this demonstration here to gain public perceptions that you can hear it, you can see that the technology works and is safe, and also that the noise is not an issue at all. And we are looking forward also to collaborate over here, obviously, to begin operation of that kind. Our pilot will now, I think, perform a short stop here and bow to the authorities here and to you as a ground. So you see, those aircrafts are very easy to maneuver. And now Paul will say thank you to the audience. Maybe give him a wink. So he's bowing and saying thank you. Thank you for this demonstration. So you see how easy it is to maneuver, really, those aircrafts. And with that, we will now end our flight test trial here, which was amazing. And thanks for the great collaboration with all our colleagues here. Thank you. Thank you very much. And touchdown. Thank you. Woo! Great job. Great job, team. Thanks also to our flight test team, who always makes it happen, and EDC. Thank you very much.